How's it going, everyone? Daxellz here, and of course today we're going to be reacting to the new Dunkey video. Elden Ring, of course, Dunkview. We've seen him play it before, but I think that was just him playing it and his experiences with the game, so that was kind of pog. But yeah, anyway, I'm going to say thank you to the members. Sorry I don't say this enough or often, but we do have memberships on the channel now. It's been there for quite a while. Jackbird421, Rice Curry, and of course, Ryan Reacts. Thank you, all three of you, for being members. If you want to become a member, it's down below near the subscribe button. But if you can't, that is okay. It is completely fine. Your subscribing and commenting and just being here is literally more than enough. But thank you to those three and all of you for watching. Let's get straight into the reaction. Okay, I wonder what the initial review is going to be. Because he loves Dark Souls, right? And he loves to swear. He loves to swear it and die, so he's gonna love it. Okay, and away we go.
Elden Ring is the biggest game ever made. When you start, the map is like this, and you go, damn, this game is big.
Then you get
teleported to the other side of the map and realize, oh my god, this game is big. Then you get teleported to the top of the map, and you go, whoa! Then you realize there's an entire other world underground, and a floating island, and a massive city, and an entire secret castle. Two of them, actually.
This will probably get game of the year.
Within secret zones, within secret zones.
Not gonna lie.
So the absolute highest compliment I can pay this game is to tell you that I have beaten this game four times now.
Right
out the gate, we're ripping off Zelda. You literally wake up in a tomb, open a big door, and the game says go. No hand-holding, no bullshit, just go wherever you want to go.
Fair enough.
Don't fight that guy, and don't go over here because you'll die, and don't follow the beam of light because
do whatever you want, but
scam.
Elden Ring's difficulty is hard.
Loop is to put a bullshit boss in front of you and say, okay, now go into the world and find something to chop his head off with. Having a concrete goal, like defeating a scumbag
boss,
makes exploration feel that much more meaningful. And visually, this is a world worth exploring. Walking around in this game is like stepping inside of a painting. There are hundreds upon hundreds of scenic vistas which look impossibly curated and intentional, and the spaces in between are populated with an absurd array of creative enemies and bosses. FromSoft is famous for their enemy design, and they are really bringing the heat here, not only in sheer quantity, but also in terms of moves and variety. Penguins, doggy statues, doggy wizards, giant lobsters, vampire bats that sing the Halo theme. They got pumpkin head, stretchy lizard man. The list goes on and on, and you're saying, Dunkey, please don't spoil this game for me, but I can't. This game cannot be spoiled because this game does not end, okay? This is Dark Souls 4, no end credits edition. But what's frustrating is that for all the effort that has gone into the world and enemies, it feels like they only spent 10 seconds balancing this game. The difficulty in this game is best described as, what is the word I'm looking for here? Total horseshit. This is an evil game made by an evil man, and whoever's job it was to balance the damage scaling on enemies show up to work for the entire making of this game. Just from saying that, people are pissed off at me. They're saying, Dunkey sucks, I hate you, Dunkey, nitpicking and biased, you only like Xbox, but always remember, I beat this, and this is fucking stupid.
Yeah, and that's
I beat Elden Ring 1, 2, 3, 4 times.
My man.
Because I'm the realest gamer of all time.
And I agree. I believe
it's too hard. I am calling this game out.
Too hard?
Not because it's a bad game, but because it's an incredible game.
That was funny when he got killed by that.
Very poor balancing. Many of your deaths in this game do not feel earned, like dying to this stupid shit, losing 70,000 runes to the wonky platforming. So many enemies in this game can kill you in one or two hits, or kill you with a combo that comes out so fast it feels like one hit, or they can stun you into another hit.
I get what he's saying. I hate games that make you feel like using a papier-mâché sword and you're literally doing no damage, so I can understand.
Which also feels like a one-hit kill, or they can just kill you in one grab, straight up. Having super aggressive enemies with crazy combos and unpredictable attacks is the fun kind of difficult. But making those moves hit for your entire health bar is fucking lame and cheap rewards. Now, what's fun about Elden Ring's rewards is you never know what you're gonna get. What sucks about that is you end up struggling in a cave for an hour to get a wizard staff that you can't even use. Look at this.
Wow.
He cannot actually turn around to attack you. He is worth 3,300 XP. Then you have this guy who can do this. And he has this move too.
This guy is sick.
Has a ton of health, by the way, is worth 3,800 XP. Only 500 more than the guy who can't turn around. Ow, wah. You think that's fucked up, though? Look at these guys. Huh? They're literally sleeping. Watch what happens when I hit L2.
Yo!
I just got 20,000 XP for it. There are so many different weapons and spells and summons and special moves in this game that should make Elden Ring a wonderland for experimentation, but because the upgrade system is so rigid and stingy, you feel discouraged from creating wacky builds. And then on top of you have this late game difficulty spike where it feels like your character just got
that fingers
back to level 1. The end game bosses are so brutal and so fast that it ultimately funnels every player into using the same broken builds. It's probably starting to sound like I hate this game, but try to remember, I beat this big ass game 4 times. 4.5 actually. Clearly they did something right. Games like this are far and few between, so I want them to get this one just right. And the good news is that most of the problems with Elden Ring can be fixed by one dude with a slider tool. Just turn enemy damage down by 20, 30, 70%, and
Okay, good review. I actually like that. I'm actually surprised he wants it to be easier, because I hear a lot of people that play these games want it to be harder, but put pain on themselves. So it's nice that someone that actually plays the game agrees that they should turn down the difficulty a little bit. good video. And you gotta want to emit psychological damage towards yourself if you want to play them type of games. But it was a very good video, very fun. I enjoyed it. If you enjoyed that video, make sure you check out the original in the description down below. Go like Dunkey's video. If you want to check out more reactions to other things, I've reacted to quite a lot of Dunkey videos. I don't know if YouTube suggested it, but it might be there. There's a lot of suggestions there that YouTube think you might like. And then also, there's one up there, which is the newest reaction, or the second newest reaction if you're watching the newest reaction. You can also subscribe by hitting this over here. I will see you in the next video. I hope you have a good day. Laters.